Hi students, welcome to first year commerce class. So we are discussing some topics which we have left earlier. Prior we have discussed very very important topics. Now again missed out topics I am taking up. As part of that, I am taking corporate social responsibility of business. Corporate social responsibility of business. What do you mean by responsibility? Means when you have to perform something towards someone, it is called as responsibility. Like, see, what is my responsibility? Completing the syllabus on time, explaining in a proper manner. So that is my responsibility as a lecturer. So what is your responsibility as a student? To study, revise the topics taught well in advance, prepare well for your exams, okay, be disciplined. That is your responsibility. Like that, everyone will have some obligations to fulfill. The obligations which we have to fulfill as part of our job, as part of our profession, is called as responsibility. Similarly, every business organization has got certain obligations towards society, because everyone is part of society. Even though you are Ambani, Adani, okay, Bill Gates, anyone, any business entrepreneur, every businessman is part of society. So it is their responsibility to protect the interest of the individual people, to safeguard their interest by providing better quality goods and by benefiting the society in various manners. Corporate social responsibility doesn't mean just by giving some charity you fulfill your responsibility. It is not like that. Okay, so you need to put efforts in order to develop the society in an overall manner. So that is the reason the corporate social responsibility of business is divided into various categories. So in this class, we are going to discuss about the social responsibility of business towards the owners. Okay, so whenever a business organization is formed, is organized, is established by certain owners, as you all know, who is the owner? The person who has invested the capital into the business organization is called as a owner. So what responsibility the business has got towards the owner is, it has to run the business efficiently. First of all, every business organization, after its establishment, it has to work in an effective manner. Because if it doesn't run effectively, the overall purpose, the overall objective for which the business organization was established will be flop. Ultimately, many people will struggle. For example, we have established a junior college. What is the purpose of establishment of this junior college? To provide quality education. How can you provide quality education if you run your college in an effective manner or in an inefficient manner? Unless until you run the college in an efficient manner, like by providing better faculty, by having better infrastructure, okay, by managing good relations with the parents and students, communication system properly about marks and exams, etc., etc. So if proper care is taken about the overall development of the students and the employees, then only the college will run effectively. But once the students have joined and you are not bothered about the syllabus completed and in better teaching, just we have taken ordinary lecturers, they don't teach well, then what is the use? So ultimately many people will struggle, because many people will have a lot of interest in the success of any organization. So first of all, the business organization has to run in an effective manner, in an efficient manner. The second and very very important thing is proper utilization of capital and other resources. See, in order to establish a business organization, some crores of capital is being procured from various parts of the society through various sources. Like, we have issued shares, we have issued bonds. You all know how we collect money from the people. So when a lot of capital is being accumulated, when we have taken money from the people to start and run a business organization, that money should be used in a proper manner. If you waste it, means by purchasing the unnecessary machinery, or by overpaying someone, or by wasting raw material, etc. If money is wasted, it is not only the waste of your business organization resource, but it is a wastage of the country, wastage of the nation. So never waste any resource. So you have to use it in a proper manner. Similarly, other resources also, like whatever you got, land, labor, okay, then raw material, power, etc., anything is there, you make use of it to the optimum level, time. If you waste any resource, means you are losing your, okay, production capacity, you are losing your business opportunities. The third one is growth and appreciation of capital. What do you mean by appreciation of capital? Suppose if you invest 2 lakhs rupees in a company by purchasing shares, after 2 or 3 years, that 2 lakhs should become 3 lakhs or 2.5 lakhs. Like you all know, maybe your parents or your relatives may be purchasing land, open plots at different areas of, okay, your locality or maybe to the nearest area. Why do we buy land? We assume that today if we invest 10 lakhs, after 5 years it will become 20 lakhs. That is called appreciation. Means value badna. So every investor's interest is whatever they are investing in shares or bonds, that value must appreciate. So when it can appreciate? When the company performs well, when the company earns profits, so the reputation, the goodwill of the company will increase in the market. So that will lead to the appreciation of investment. Then regular and fair return on capital. Many times I told you, any fund provider, any financial institution which provides you capital, maybe a shareholder or a debenture holder or a public deposit holder, any person or any bank, any financial company which provides you capital, they expect a proper return on it. Okay, like you pay fees to the college, what do you expect? A quality education, a quality teaching. When you buy a product by paying some price, you expect the product should be good quality. Similarly, when the shareholders invest money into a joint stock company, they expect proper dividend every year. So the company can give the dividend only when it functions efficiently. Only when the company earns profits, it can give you the dividend. Similarly, debenture holders expect interest. So when company earns profits, then only all these rewards can be paid. So that's how every investor will expect. You have to fulfill their expectations. So that is what called regular and fair return on capital. Then towards employees, what a business organization has to deal with employees, what it has to do, in what way it has to fulfill its responsibility towards employees. First one, all employees of any organization, whether it is a hospital, college, restaurant or a bakery, every employee working in the organization always expects timely salaries. That is the first thing every employer, even in future also, if you become the employer, you remember this. Even at your home, if a maid is there, if a servant is working, agar aapke paas driver kaam kar raha, so remember this point that you give them the salary on time. That is the first responsibility of every employer, not a big business organization, even as a individual person also. Okay, if someone is working at our home, maybe a servant is working, a driver is working, a gardener is working, okay, for them you have to pay salary promptly. That gives them more satisfaction, so employees will work with, okay, utmost motivated nature, then that will give better result to the organization. So the first responsibility is timely, regular and fair payment. Fair payment means whatever they deserve, means according to their work. Never exploit them, means don't take extra work and pay less. Whatever they are doing the work, according to the work you pay the salary. Then proper working conditions, means you provide them the proper facilities like safety measures. People are working heights and working on cranes, give them helmets. People are working in science laboratories, give them the safe jackets, etc., shoe. Proper working conditions means good machinery, proper tools, because employees or workers should not struggle in your organization. Okay, like say if a lecturer is coming and the board is not good, he is troubling to write, means it is a improper condition. You provide them the proper facility, then he will be satisfied. So like that, we have to provide proper working conditions. Then opportunity for better career prospects. What do you mean by career prospects? Employee has to induce more and more skills. He should be promoted to the higher levels. Okay, so you give them the scope to learn. You conduct various workshops, give them training, ask them to learn new things. So elevate them to the higher positions. Then The fourth one, very important, is job security and social security. Job security means always employee is not to be worried about his job. Means he is working here, whether the next month job is there or not, such type of dilemma should not be there for any employee or worker. He should be told that, yes, you are here with the organization as long as you never commit any mistake. So we are going to keep your job, keep you retained with us. So you will be working with us for a long period of time. There is no threat for your job. So be peace of mind. If you tell like that, the employee will be working in a peaceful manner. And social security means after retirement, some pension, insurance, provident fund. If you give this type of benefits, the employee feels secured. Then he will work, okay, with great zeal to achieve great success. So these are the responsibility of business towards owners and employees. Then in the next class, we will discuss some more.